What steps do we follow with performing a binary search? Well, first, we need an input of an array sorted in ascending or descending order and a target value. Then we initialize two index variables, commonly known as low and high, which initially point to the beginning and the ending indices of the array, respectively. Alternatively, you can go with names like left and right or I and J. If you're feeling fancy, you can even use names like Bert and Ernie. Next, we calculate the value of the third index variable called mid. This variable points to the element that sits right in the middle of the elements pointed to by low and high. As we progress, either high decreases or low increases, and mid is repositioned accordingly. We stop the process either when the mid index points to an element that matches our target, at which point we return the mid index, or when high becomes less than low, in which case we return -1. In my previous video, I had explained the concept of binary search and demonstrated its manual execution. If you haven't watched it yet, I highly recommend taking a few minutes to do so. It will greatly benefit you in understanding and relating to the code I'm about to write. Alright, now that we are on the same page, let's begin coding by considering an example of an array sorted in ascending order. As mentioned, we use two index variables, low and high. Initially, low is set to 0, indicating the first element, while high is set to length of array -1, representing the last element of the array. We then begin a while loop with the condition low is less than or equal to high. This ensures that the loop continues as long as the condition is met, allowing us to search within the specified range. Now let's move on to the next step and calculate the index of the middle element of the array referred to as mid. In the case of an array with even number of elements, such as ours, the middle elements are located at index 9 and 10. To handle this scenario, we consider the left one as the middle element. To find the middle index, we add the values of the low and high indices and divide the sum by 2 using the double forward slash operator in Python. This operator represents the float division or integer division, returning the largest integer less than or equal to the division result. Using a forward single slash for division would give us a mid index value of 9.5. But since we cannot have half of an element, we prefer float division. It's worth noting that double forward slash operator also works correctly for arrays with an odd number of elements. So, to calculate the mid index value, we simply write the expression mid equals low plus high forward double slash 2. Now, before moving on to the next step, let's identify a few scenarios or target that we'll be working with in our code. Currently, there are three possibilities we need to consider. The first possibility is when the middle element is equal to our target. In this case, we have successfully found the position of the target we were searching for. The second possibility arises when the middle element is greater than the target. The third possibility occurs when the middle element is less than the target. These three scenarios encompass the various situations we'll be addressing in our code to ensure a comprehensive binary search implementation. Let's use 40 as the target and cover the first possibility. If array of mid equals the target, we return mid. In this case, we return the index 9. Now let's move on to the second possibility. We will consider the target 5 or 23, which are both lesser than the middle element 40. To handle this scenario, we write an if statement if array of mid is greater than target. If the middle element array of mid is indeed greater than the target, we need to adjust our search range by updating the value of high to mid -1. This helps narrow down the search range, as explained in my previous video on binary search manual execution. If you haven't seen it yet, I recommend watching it before continuing here. So, to implement this adjustment, we write high equals mid -1. This step ensures that we search for the target in the lower half of the array, refining our search further. Before we continue with the targets 5 and 23, let's take a step back and explore the other targets, especially 99 and 100. This will help us cover the third possibility where the middle element array of mid is lesser than the target. To address this, we need to adjust our search range accordingly. We can accomplish this by writing an else statement which takes care of the situation where array of mid is less than target. If the middle element is indeed smaller than the target, we narrow down our search range by updating the value of low to mid +1. So, to implement this adjustment, we write low equals mid plus 1. This modification ensures we continue searching for the target in the upper half of the array, refining our search process further. With this, our while loop is now complete. Let's continue and conclude with these two target examples. Continuing the execution within the while loop, we observe that the value of low is still less than high. As a result, we recalculate the mid index using the updated values of low and high. In this specific scenario, our target is 99, which happens to be the middle number as well. Consequently, we satisfy the condition if array of mid equals target. Upon meeting this condition, we return the value of mid, which in this case is 14. This marks the end of the program execution. However, if the target is 100 instead, the condition if array of mid equals target will not be satisfied. In such a case, we proceed with the next step and check if array of mid is greater than the target. If this condition is also not satisfied, we move to the else part of the code. The else part of the code handles the scenario where array of mid is less than the target. In this situation, we need to adjust our search range by increasing the value of low to mid plus 1. This adjustment ensures that we continue searching for the target in the upper half of the array. Now, with the smaller array, we continue iterating through the while loop given that the low is still less than high. We recalculate the value of mid with the updated values of low and high and check if it equals the target. Since it doesn't, we move forward and check if the middle element is greater than the target. It satisfies this condition, so we update the value of high to mid minus 1. With a narrowed down array of 2 elements, we iterate through the loop. After recalculating the mid value, we check if it matches the target 100. Since it doesn't, we move to the next condition where we determine that the middle element 102 is greater than the target 100. Consequently, we update the value of high to mid minus 1. Upon reaching the last check of the while loop's condition, we find that it is no longer fulfilled due to low being greater than high. As a result, we exit from the while loop and determine that the target value of 100 is not present in the given array. In such situation, it is customary to return minus 1, indicating the absence of the target value. Up to this point, we have explored target examples such as 40, 99, and 100, successfully completing the program. However, as I mentioned earlier, let's now revert to the original state and proceed with the code to cover scenarios involving target values of 5 and 23. Moving on to the while loop, we confirm that the condition is satisfied, allowing us to recalculate the value of mid. In this case, mid is assigned a value of 9. Next, we check if the value at index 9 matches the target we are searching for. Well, it does not fulfill the criteria for either 5 or 23 as the target. Proceeding to the next if condition, we observe that it is met since the middle element 40 is greater than the target values, whether be it 5 or 23. Consequently, we adjust the value of high by reducing it to mid minus 1. If our target is 23, we encounter the if condition where the middle element equals the target. As a result, we return the value of mid. It's important to note that in this array, there are two elements with the same value of 23. The program simply returns the index of the occurrence it finds first. In a separate video, I'll demonstrate how to specifically search for the first or last occurrence of a target value in a sorted array using binary search concepts. However, in this case, whichever occurrence of 23 is found first, the program returns the index of that particular occurrence. Therefore, in this scenario, we return the index 4. Now, if the target is 5 instead of 23, the current if condition is not satisfied. Consequently, we move on to the next if condition where we check if the middle element 23 is greater than 5. As it turns out, the condition is met, indicating the middle element is indeed greater than the target. To adjust our search range accordingly, we decrease the value of high by setting it to mid minus 1. This modification ensures that we focus our search on the lower portion of the remaining array elements. In the next iteration of the while loop, we set mid to 1. However, since the middle element minus 2 is not the target, we move to the next if condition, which is also not satisfied. Consequently, we proceed to the else part and update the value of low to mid plus 1. Continuing the loop with low still less than high, we update mid to 2. However, since the middle element 4 is neither the target 5 nor greater than it, we proceed to the else part and set low to mid plus 1. In the last iteration of the while loop, where low and high are equal, we set mid to 3. Since 23 is not our target, we update high to mid minus 1. As we evaluate the condition of the while loop, we observe that it is not satisfied because the value of low is greater than high. Therefore, we do not execute the loop and return minus 1 instead, indicating that the target value is not present in the given array. In our final scenario, let's consider the case where the input array is empty. In such a situation, the variable low is initialized to 0 and high is initialized to length of array minus 1, which evaluates to 0 minus 1. As a result, the condition of the while loop is not satisfied since low is already greater than high. Consequently, the function directly returns minus 1, indicating that the target value cannot be found in an empty array. Now let's explore the recursive implementation of the binary search algorithm. Interestingly, not much changes compared to the iterative version. We can set default values for the parameters where the value of low is 0 and the value of high is length of array minus 1. To handle the scenario where low becomes greater than high, we return minus 1. This serves as the base case of the recursion. Next, we implement the logic that was previously inside the while loop. We calculate the midpoint using the same logic and check if it matches the target. If it does, we return the midpoint. We then proceed to the if condition, where we check if array of mid is greater than the target. In this case, we simply return the result of the binary search function by passing the updated high index value parameter as mid minus 1. Similarly, in the else part, we return the result of the binary search function by passing the updated low index value parameter as mid plus 1. With these changes, we now have the code for implementing binary search using recursion. In binary search algorithm, the search is performed by manipulating the indices within the given array, without the need for additional data structure or dynamically growing memory. As a result, the space complexity of binary search is order of 1, indicating that the amount of memory used remains constant regardless of the input size. On the other hand, the time complexity of binary search is order of log n. To delve into the details and understand why it is logarithmic, I invite you to stay tuned for my upcoming video where I explain the intricacies of the time complexity of binary search. Thank you for watching, and I appreciate your support.